Hey everyone, Kyle here with this week's coach's tip. This week I want to talk a bit about isometric training. There are two main types of isometrics, that is yielding and overcoming. Yielding isometrics is resisting eccentric forces, aka gravity, aka the lowering phase of some movement. Overcoming isometrics is pushing against an immovable object as hard as you can. So for yielding isometrics, this might look like a holding of a lunge position with the knee just off the ground, and you're holding that for as long as you can at about RPE 7 to 8. Now, RPE 7 to 8 in this instance, because you can't measure reps, would be something that is equivalent to around 20 to 30 seconds away from failure. So if you felt like in 20, 30 seconds, I will not be able to hold this position before, you're getting in to a good range. And then you can increase that week to week by doing 10 to 20 seconds away from failure or even to failure. These will be quite challenging sets, and you potentially are going to be holding these positions for a long time. You could do that with any joint position. So again, that could be a lunges, that could be the bottom of a push-up just off the ground, that could be a quarter squat. You can get really inventive in how you might use this. And you might want to think about, like I said, joint positions or the angles that your limbs are taking relevant to how you used to train before. Overcoming isometrics would be something that would be a little bit more max output, something like equivalent to a 1 RM in a squat or a 5 RM in a squat. And how you would think about this is you want to accumulate some sort of max effort time in the 10 to 15 rep range or seconds range rather. And you might do that with something that's like a 5-5. So you push as hard as you can for 5 seconds, rest 5 seconds, as hard as you can for 5 seconds, rest 5 seconds, as hard as you can again. So that achieves that 15-second kind of window there, but allows you to have really good quality sets with a bit of rest in between. Some ways you could use this is pushing against a towel in a squat position. So you could put the towel underneath your feet, hold the ends, and then push against the ground as hard as you can, trying to rip the towel. You'll feel that in your back, in your legs, pretty much anywhere. Another way you can implement these is in a doorway. So you could get wedged in between a door so that your leg is at approximately about 90 degrees and push as hard as you can, trying to push the door away as your back goes in to the door frame behind you. So both of these type of isometrics are great at home training. The yielding would be equivalent to more of your hypertrophy training, and the overcoming isometrics would be kind of your maximal training. So that way you can stimulate both ends of the spectrum.